Now in this section, we'll see how to configure a router to do the job of a DHCP server and how we can make a router to do the job of a DHCP and what are the configurations we need to add to make a router to do the job of a DHCP. Now here in my scenario, I'm going to use some computers in the LAN and these specific computers will be referred as my DHCP clients, which are supposed to get the IP address from the DHCP server. And now in my scenario, the router 1, which is also a default gateway, not only that, it is also doing the job of a DHCP server. So we are going to configure some range of addresses on the DHCP and we are expecting the clients to get the IP addresses based on the range given on the DHCP server. Now the first thing, we need to create a DHCP pool, and we can create by using IP DHCP pool and any name for the pool. So I'm using CCIE as a name. Now after that, you can always use iOS help to see the possible options. We need to tell who is the gateway, because once we tell that information to the DHCP, then DHCP will provide that information inside that DHCP messages. So we need to tell who is the router. Now in my scenario, the router is default router is 192.168.1.100, and I'm saying that the same information has to be propagated to the clients. Now, if you have some DNS servers, probably you can tell who are the DNS servers so that the client will get automatically the DNS information also. Like here, even I'm saying obtain the DNS automatically. So if you want to go to internet or access any servers on the internet, you must know the DNS server address. And even I'm going to tell the DNS server information on the DHCP server, and the DHCP server will provide that information to the clients. And then we need to tell what is the network you want to use. So right now I want to use 192.168.1.network by using /24 subnet mask. So we need to define the range of the addresses or the network range which you want to use and who is your gateway, so that it can provide the same information to the clients. And then you need to tell the DNS server information. So if you don't want DNS, you can skip that one, but probably in the production networks you will have some DNS servers which will help you to go to internet. And then there are some optional parameters also we can configure, like exclude addresses. Now exclude addresses are the addresses which should not be assigned to any device in the network. Like here we are using 192.168.1.network, in that we are already using 192.168.1.100, which is the default gateway. And this address, we need to ensure that it should not be assigned to any device in the client, in the network. If it assigns 1.100, then there is a possibility of conflict. Any one of the device will not work, and we don't want that. And we can exclude other addresses, like maybe just for example wise, I'm using 1.1 to 1.10. So 1.1 to 1.10, I'm excluding. Maybe I'm using 1.1 for my one of the server, FTP server, which is a static IP. Maybe 1.2 I'm using for my web server, like that. I have some server, firewalls, some special devices, and I'm using this address range, and I don't want this address to be assigned to any device in the network. And also I don't want to assign this address also, because these are my DNS server address. So we can always exclude the addresses which you don't want, which are defined in the range. So let's go to the command line to verify the same here. Now I got my topology in the packet tracer here, where on this switch I have all the connections, and on the switch, if you know the switching feature called spanning tree port fast, I have enabled spanning tree port fast on all the ports. Because of the default spanning tree, it goes to listening learning stages, and whenever you make the interface up, it will take 30 seconds of time, and I don't want that particular 30 seconds delay for my DHCP packets. So your DHCP service may not work if the STP is converging. So this I'm disabling that by enabling port fast. Now port fast is something, is a feature which we to speed up the convergence time. So we discussed that in the switching topics. Now here we got the connection, and the router 1 is doing the job of a DHCP, and on the router 1 I already configured the IP addresses, and that's it. So I want to make the router 1 to do the job of a DHCP server. So it's an IP DHCP pool, any name for the pool. And you can always use question mark here. Like the default router, it's 192.168.1.100. And then the DNS server, maybe 192.168.1.50. I don't have that device, just for verify, I'm just giving this option. And the network, what is the network you want to use? So I'm using 192.168.1.network with a /24 subnet mask. Now after that, we need to just get back, and we can exclude some addresses. Like, I'm going to exclude the address 192.168.1.100, and I'm excluding 1.1 to 1.10 just for testing purpose, and then I'm also excluding 1.50 as well. So these are the addresses which should not be assigned to the clients, even though they come under the range of 192.168.1.network. Now to verify this, we need to go to the computers. Already there is a DHCP, so I'll go to ipconfig and I'll say simply obtain the IP address automatically. You can see when you do this, you can see the DHCP request was successful, and I got the IP address 1.11, because 1.1 to 1.10 is reserved for, we actually excluded them, and you can see the default gateway as well as the DNS information. Now probably if you're testing this lab on the real devices, probably you can use a command called ipconfig/release. You can select this option, ipconfig/release, and then you can say ipconfig/renew. Now this method will renew the IP address process, release the existing IP, and renew the process. Now similar way, if you want to do the same thing on the other devices, just you can select DHCP requesting the IP address, and you can see the DHCP request was successful because we have configured the router 1 to do the job of a DHCP server. Now apart from that, if I just get back to this command line, you can also make a router to do the job of DHCP server. Like if you are testing this lab on the routers, maybe you don't want to connect to PC, and you want the router to get the IP address from the DHCP server. This is more common scenario where you have a router connecting to the LAN and it is connecting to ISP, and on the ISP side probably you have a DHCP server, and the DHCP server is going to assign the IP address to your public IP. Whatever the IP on the interface is assigned via DHCP server. Now we can go to this interface, whatever the interface, let's say it is S1/0. I can simply say IP address and then DHCP. So which means I'm not assigning the IP address on this interface. Instead, I'm saying that to get the IP address automatically from the via DHCP server. Now this command is equivalent to the command which we use in our options here. If you just get back to these options here, this one, selecting this option. And we can also do that, and that's what we will do here. I'll try to connect one router, assuming that I have a client router, and this client router needs to get an IP address from the DHCP server, that is router 1. So I'm going to connect that particular router to this port, and then I'll go to the command line of the client, and on the client I'm going to say hostname is client, DHCP client, and I'm going to interface F0/0, and I'll say IP address DHCP, which means it should get the IP address from the DHCP server, and then no shutdown command. Now once I give no shutdown command, if you verify show IP interface brief, I should see the IP address on the client. Let me check one more time the configurations. So IP address DHCP. Let me try to shut down the port once and back to no shutdown. I'm expecting the client should provide me the IP addresses. So if I give show IP interface brief. So let me do some troubleshooting. Actually, I have configured IP address DHCP, but it didn't took the command on the interface. Let me try one more time. Now you can see it has taken the IP address now. It just takes some time. You can see interface F0/0 assigned the IP address of 1.13 via DHCP. And if you verify show IP interface brief, it takes some time. And you can see 1.13 has been assigned because 1.11, 1.12 and 1.13. So we didn't use this for these devices. If you want, we can go and verify the same on the remaining computers. Now, probably we can use a router to do the job of a DHCP server, which is more applicable in a small size network. But if you're running a big size network, you need to go with a separate dedicated servers like Windows or Linux servers, which will do the job of a DHCP. Now, in the Cisco syllabus, we are going to cover DHCP, where we can also use a router to do the job of a DHCP. But practically, it's really not recommended because it is going to increase the load on the routers. It is best suited for the network which are having 10 to 15 users or very small number of clients. But if you have a huge number of clients, it's recommended to go with the external DHCP server running a Microsoft or a Linux operating systems.